Sing hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Worthy. to the Bethlehem Baptist Church, a Christ-centered multicultural church where our mission is to love God and serve people. We pray that as you view this service, that you will be blessed by the word of God, by the songs of praises, and that you will know that God is there for us every step of the way. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Let us pray. Our gracious and glorious God, we are privileged and blessed to be able to assemble this morning to worship you. We pray, O God, that you might find our hearts and minds open. We might worship you in spirit and in truth. Bless every worshiper who comes through these doors. Bless, O God, the songs of praise that we sing. Bless, O God, the prayers that we utter. Bless, O God, the gifts that we bring. And bless, O God, the words that's proclaimed, that it might strengthen us, encourage us, and even convict us. May we leave better than we came. In Jesus' name do we pray. And all of God's people say together, amen, 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 and amen. You may be seated. Come on, Agape. Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah. We just encourage you to take this time to reflect on the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done, how mighty and how great he is. We worship him on this morning. Hallelujah.
Give him praise.
We give you praise. Lord, we give you praise. We give you praise. Lord, we give you praise. Come on and sing. All Lord, We give you praise, Lord, we give you praise. Has he been good to anybody? We
you
on, church, let's sing.
Hallelujah.
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 Does anybody want to tell them that we love you? Lord, we love you.
Bethlehem, I ask that you stand on your feet. Join me in the sacred task this morning of reading this morning's text, which we will find in the book of Matthew, the 13th chapter, verses 1 through 8. Amen. Later that same day, Jesus left the house and sat beside the lake. A large crowd soon gathered around him, so he got into a boat. Then he sat there and taught as the people stood on the shore. He told many stories in the form of parables, such as this one. Listen, a farmer went out to plant some seed. As he scattered them across the field, some seeds fell on a footpath, and the birds came and ate them. Other seeds fell on shallow soil with underlying rock. The seeds sprouted quickly because the soil was shallow. But the plants soon withered under the hot sun. And since they didn't have deep roots, they died. Other seeds fell along thorns that grew up and choked out the tender plants. Still other seeds fell on fertile soil, and they produced a crop that was 30, 60, and even 100 times as much as had been planted. The word of the Lord.
Our hymn of celebration this morning is found on number 32. Please stand as we sing our hymn of celebration.
Thank you.
second week of this new year, and already we have seen a number of deaths in the life of this congregation. I'm going to ask if Brenda Benson would come and just share with us those who are standing in need of prayer, as well as those who have experienced the loss of loved ones. She'll read a letter later, but I want her to read that list of those individuals. And every day, somebody else calls the church and shares their grief as a result of a family member. Can you just read those names this morning?
Good morning, church. We want to keep in prayer, first of all, Debbie Badger, whose mother was put in intensive care on yesterday. Also, we want to please keep in prayer the following members who have lost loved ones. Janice Johnson's sister was funeralized on Friday. Barbara Pennock's aunt was funeralized on yesterday. Barbara Jones's mother, she just lost her father just recently, will be funeralized on Tuesday at White Rock. Ellery and Paul Sumler lost their mother. That service will be here at Bethlehem on Friday. Reverend Smalls lost a family member. And Jessica Lanier called Pastor yesterday, and she lost her brother.
Just a brief list of those who have.
Oh, I apologize. Michael Anthony's mother will be funeralized here on Thursday.
I believe I saw Barbara. Is Barbara Jones there? I'm going to ask if Reverend Betty Wright Riggins would just go sit next to her. Reverend Betty Wright Riggins has a heart for those who are grieving, and I can't even put into words the pain of losing a father and then almost 3 weeks later losing your mother. I will be attending that service on Tuesday and sharing the service on Thursday and Friday here for Michael Anthony and the other family. And so I pray that you would join hands with someone, and you don't know what they're going through. Just pray for one another this morning. Take a look at the sick list and see the many names that are there. And thank God your name is not on the list today. Today.
Let us look to the Lord. Father God, as we begin our walk with you in this new decade, we look back on the previous decade and the previous year and just thank you for all the blessings that you bestowed on us. We thank you for being a healer. We thank you for being a comforter. We thank you for fighting our battles. And Lord, we thank you for blessing us when we weren't even expecting it or even asked for it. And Father, we thank you doubly because we know there are things that we have done that are not pleasing in your eye. So we thank you for your grace and your mercy. And we confess and ask for forgiveness. And in this year, 2020, we pledge to study, continue to study your word, continue to read devotions, continue to pray for forgiveness, pray for obedience, pray. And now, Lord, we pray for others, others that are maybe going through a little valley right now, going through a little storm. As Brenda just told us, there's a number of people who have, you've already called home, mothers, fathers, siblings, aunts, uncles. We just ask you to comfort the bereaved. Comfort them, put your arms of love around them, and give them comfort in knowing that you only called those loved ones home because they fulfilled the plans you had for them, and that because of their lives, our lives are a lot better. We pray, Lord, for those who are sick and shut in. The list in our bulletin just continues to grow. And so we ask you to send your angels in the form of doctors and nurses and prescriptions and caretakers and minister to them, Lord, that make their souls comfortable while you minister to their flesh, to their bodies, Lord. We pray for the people in Puerto Rico, Argentina, and other countries that are going through devastations. One of our sisters just came back from Puerto Rico, and she said that the people there were encouraging the visitors there because they know that they're in God's hands. So do we just continue, we just ask you to continue to uplift them, Lord. We pray for our pastor, Lord. He just keeps going and going and going. So we thank you for his energy. And you just pray that you continue giving him his help. And as he brings the word today, we ask that it reach out to one person who might not know you yet, Lord, and convict them to walk down that red carpet into your arms, Lord. We pray for the officers that are being installed today, Lord. And we thank the officers that are going out for their contributions and for their growth. And now, Lord, we just ask you that for the officers that are coming in, we ask you to replace their egos with trust. Trust in the Lord, my favorite scripture. Trust in the Lord in all you do and lean not on your own inclinations. In all your ways, acknowledge you, and he will direct our paths. Replace their indecisions or uncertainties with faith. Faith that just needs to be as small as a mustard seed. Because we know, God, you can do everything but fail. And then we just ask you to replace their impatience with waiting on the Lord. Again, your word says, those that wait on the Lord will get strong. They will rise up on wings like eagles. They will run and not be weary. They will walk and not faint. So leave that with our new officers, Lord. You're such an awesome God, and we just praise your name. So we just ask all these things in the magnificent name of your son, Jesus Christ. Let the church say hallelujah.
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 Amen.
Amen.
Give him praise. Give him praise.
Church, if you are visiting or for the first time or you're a guest, would you please stand and remain standing?
Amen.
Amen. All right, so welcome to Bethlehem Baptist Church. We are a Christ-centered, multicultural church. We love the Lord. We love each other. And welcome to our congregation. If by chance you have not found the home church, feel free to consider this church. As you see, it's a group of warm people. We love each other. We have service on twice on Sunday, 9 a.m. and 11:15. We have Bible study throughout the week. I don't quite frankly think there's a day when the doors go quiet in this church throughout the week. And we have a food pantry that provides food and services. There are pantry angels there that provide prayer. It's just an awesome, awesome, awesome branch of Zion. Thank you for coming and joining us today, and welcome to our church.
Amen. Now, just in case somebody didn't feel warm and welcome, turn to somebody and say, I'm glad to be sitting near you. I'm going to ask now, we turn our attention to BET, Bethlehem Evangelistic Television.
Good morning, Bethlehem. This is Reverend Holloman, and welcome to the BET. The ENS Ministries is joining with Salem Baptist Church for the annual historical student tour for college-bound students. It will be held April 4th through the 9th. The cost is $500, and seating will be limited. An information session is being held today at 12:30 p.m. in their Salem School Building. Or see any member of the ENS Ministry for additional information. Now, here are two important messages from the senior ministry. Here's Diane.
Believe it or not, Valentine's Day is right around the corner. Are you ready to treat your sweetie? Here's the perfect gift. The BBC Senior Ministry is sponsoring a Valentine dinner for four. The dinner will include a delicious dessert and delivery to your door. Raffle ticket cost is only $5. Drawing to be held after 9 a.m. worship service on Sunday, February 2nd. Tickets will be on sale in the cafe after each worship service. The senior prom dress giveaway is fast approaching. Thank you, Bethlehem. We have received 87 gowns and 210 pieces of cosmetics for students in our school districts who could really use them. Giveaway date is February 1st from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. If you are interested in helping these young ladies choose a beautiful dress, see me in the cafe.
Save the date, January birthday folks. Next Sunday, January 19th, we will celebrate you in our own BBC fashion. Be here to sit in an area reserved just for you as we praise the Lord for each one of you. Marriages can become stale. Here's an opportunity to revisit, refresh, revive your yes. If you or your ministry would like to become of the BBC, contact Brenda Benson in the church office. Have a blessed week, and remember, love God and serve His people.
Be grateful to God for the leadership of this church, and I'm going to ask if those current individuals who are going to be leading ministry in 2020. Chairperson of our trustees, Darren, would you please come? Chairperson of our deaconess, Ronte. I'm working on her name. And the chairperson of our deacons, Wayne Holliday. Would you please come? We want to also thank you, and this matter of leadership is crucial, and so I'm going to ask that each of you would present a plaque on behalf of the church to those that you have picked up the mantle from. Could you open these up for me? call your name, would you please come up? That's fine. Marcia. You can call her name.
Okay, Marcia, I see you sitting there smiling. You need to come up here and stand next to me. As many of you know, leadership is a very difficult task. And Marcia, for the past 2 years, have encouraged the Deaconess Ministry. She has loved on us, and she has laid a fertile ground for me to follow, and I thank her for that. So this plaque says, presented to Marcia Potts in recognition and appreciation for extraordinary leadership as servant leader of the Deaconess Ministry, January 12, 2020. Pastor Charles, Reverend Charles Warren Kwan, Deacon Wayne Holiday, Deacon Ministry Servant Leader. My name's on here. Deaconess Ministry Servant Leader, Ronte Oates, and Trustee Ministry Servant Leader, Dr. Darren DeVoe. It says here, 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 12, I thank Christ Jesus our Lord, who has given me strength to do his work. He considered me trustworthy and appointed me to serve him.
Could you stay right here?
Morning, Church.
Morning.
Milton Oates, please come. This is kind of fun for me. Milton has provided the establishing leadership for the trustee ministry that's kind of unprecedented. He set the tone for us moving forward, specifically in the area of understanding how to leverage technology and the movement of the world and as it relates to the church. And we thank you for your guidance and support in all things. But I'm so pleased to be able to present this to you, Milton. He's also my friend. presented to Milton Oates in recognition and appreciation for extraordinary leadership as servant leader of the trustee ministry, January 12, 2020, Reverend Charles W. Kwan, Pastor, Deacon Wayne Holiday, Deacon Ministry Servant Leader, Deaconess Ronte Oates. You know her?
No.
Deaconess Ministry Servant Leader, and Trustee Darren DeVoe, Trustee Ministry Servant Leader. Milton, we thank you for everything.
Mr. Ron Bradley. It gives me great honor and great pleasure to present this plaque to you, because you know I love you, and you're just such a leader, and you're so big, but that you're a gentle giant, you know, and you got to get to know him, and then you realize that he's really a pussycat. You'll never know. So with that, in recognition and appreciation for extraordinary leadership as servant leader of the Deacon Ministry, presented January 12, 2020, Reverend Charles W. Kwan, Pastor, Deacon Wayne Holiday, Deacon Ministry Servant Leader, Deaconess Ronte Oates, Deaconess Ministry Servant Leader, and Trustee Darren DeVoe, Trustee Ministry Servant Leader. I thank Christ Jesus our Lord, who has given me strength to do this work. He considered me trustworthy and appointed me to serve him. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much.
Brother. Love you, man. Love you, brother. Go get him.
Now,
before you go, I want to take the plaques back, because I wanted the entire congregation to see how much we appreciate you. And so at the second service, when we install leadership, I want to do the same thing, because I think everyone in this church should know that we have some extraordinary leaders in this church. And our trustees rotate off, and so Milton Oates will present those certificates now to those individuals who are present who have been such a vital part of the trustee ministry. Our deacons and deaconesses do not rotate off, but the trustees do. And so we want to thank God for all of those who offer God themselves as servants of God.
Good morning. Good morning, church. We have 13 trustees rolling off this year, or rolling to the side. So, yes, it's a lot. And the first name is my vice chair. She's here, Maria Banks. Rosita Buckingham. Buckingham. Okay. Carla Birdsong. Oh, that means they're not rolling. Katrina DeWitt. Okay. Darren, all of these are going back with you. Lauren Hammond. Okay. Kenneth Lawrence. Yes. We do have one. Cynthia Leslie. Okay. I'll bring it up. Shirley Nash. Yes. Carol Rice. Carolyn Tribble. Oh.
Thomas Webster.
Barbara Jones. Carol Bingo. And Milton Oates. Thank you. Have a good day.
Yesterday, we had a phenomenal leadership breakfast, and I wanted the church to be aware of where we're going in this decade. No longer can one individual take on the awesome task of trying to do all this by themselves. So we put together what I call our leadership team, and many of those individuals will be here at our second service. But I'm going to ask that those three chairpersons that just came, if they would stand, they're part of our leadership team, chairperson of our trustees, our deacon, Deaconess, would you please stand, Bronte? Also included in our leadership team, Brenda Benson, our chief of staff, as well as our youth pastor, Reverend Sean Triplon. Prior to any joint board meeting, I will be meeting with those individuals so they will have full knowledge as what the pastor is speaking about, looking at, and it's not just an opportunity for them to hear me, but to give constructive comments regarding how we can move the church forward. At the same time, for the first time in the life of our church, we put together advisory council. They're not a government body, but they are individuals who are committed, who have expertise, and who really bring to this church a lot of energy and excitement. And some of them will be at our second service. Hopefully all of them will be at our second service, but I want you to know who they are, because I don't want any secrets in the life of this church. Heywood Bell, if you're here, would you please come down? Heywood Bell. Ron Bradley. Kia Gray. Jacqueline Cadone. Tanya Holliday. Walt Logan. Marcus Mayo, Tim Reese, Emerald Walton, and Celeste Warren. They bring to this church excitement, commitment, zeal. We have put together what I believe is a strong body of believers. Our youth is represented, diversity is represented in Jacqueline Cadone, and our first meeting will be on February the 11th, an opportunity for us to look at ways by which this church can grow. We can no longer do ministry the same way we did it in the 90s. Somebody say praise God. You may take your seat. At the same time, I put flowers on the altar for Maria Banks, who really has reached out beyond this church to see what our vendors could do. And so we have flowers on the altar for her, but in her spirit, I called Amber Flores, where we get flowers all the time, and I said to the gentleman, we want to have fresh flowers on the altar every Sunday. And what can you do? And so Jean said, Pastor, I'll put the flowers on the altar every Sunday at no cost. Now, someone asked what we're going to do with the flowers when the service is over. So here's what we're going to do with the flowers. When we do not have another service during the week, we will give the flowers at the second service to some senior or some other one who is in need of love. And so I'm going to give these flowers, and I need you to come back, for Ms. Martha Weldon, who has not been here for some time. And these flowers I'm going to give to Debbie Badger, who has done such a remarkable job. Her mother is very ill. And so we want to let her know that our love, and she's been working in technology. So every Sunday, we will give flowers to someone else. Not only that, but every first Sunday, we ask you to bring food for the alt, for the pantry. We call it First Fruit Sunday. Every Sunday, bring food to the pantry so that our pantry can have what we call choice pantry. So when people come to the pantry, they can be received with dignity. And they'll be able to receive food that will be a balance to their family. And we will not just give them something, but they'll be able to select the way we select food when we go to the market. Somebody say amen. There are a lot of new initiatives in life of the church, and some of them require change. Say, change is good. Say it like you believe change is good. And so, starting on the fourth Sunday of this month, after 9:30, that door will be closed back there, and the only way you get into the sanctuary on Sunday is come through these doors. Now, in case of emergency, you can always get out, but you can't get in that door. We want to make sure that the cafe is not a place of lounging during worship. Everybody needs to be in worship. At the same time, we've asked every ministry in the life of this church to go and take inventory of those areas in the basement, in the pantry area, all over this church. We want to be better stewards. Clean out everything, throw it out if it's not of any use. I don't hear any amens. We want to be better stewards for God, and by the end of the month, if you don't have it cleaned out, we will have our sextons ministry clean everything out. We don't want to be spending money for, and nothing belongs to anyone. So we have ample space for plates and other things, so we're not ordering things that you have not used but once a year or once a month. Amen. Amen. Please take the church directory. I would also ask that you would get a copy of the Philadelphia Tribune. I say that every week, but newspapers are going out of business. I'm still old school. I could get a cup of coffee and a newspaper, and I've discovered that the Daily News and the Inquirer print the same news. That's different. And most of the advertisement now is full in the newspaper, and very seldom you get things to read. I'm going to ask Brenda Brenson to come now and read a letter that I've written to the Amler Gazette that will be in the paper this week.
Good morning again. Life is precious. It is with a heavy heart that I pen these words, for there is much hate in this country. As an African American, I grieve with my Jewish brothers and sisters for the awful, ungodly attacks against the Jewish community. The stabbing a few weeks ago at Rabbi's home during a Hanukkah party in New York is the latest of anti-Semitism violence. I believe with all my heart that it is time for people of all walks of life to speak out against these savage crimes. As pastor of the Bethlehem Baptist Church for 33 years, I have been immensely blessed with the friendship of Rabbi Gregory Marks and the members of Congregation Beth Orr, as well as with many other synagogues in our surrounding community that have enhanced our faith journey together. Just about every day, I have lunch at Pumpernick's on Bethlehem Pike, and my wife and I go there for date night on Fridays. I have met so many wonderful people there, they have become like family. I could go on and on about the many relationships I have made, not only with our Jewish brothers and sisters, but with the North Penn Mosque in Lansdale, as well as with members of the larger Wissahickon faith community. I cannot remain silent when innocent people are slaughtered. Acts of terrorism and racial hatred cannot be tolerated in this world, in this country, or in our community. We must speak out. Our places of worship are under attack. While we were still reading about the tragedy in New York, there was a shooting in a house of worship in Texas. When will all this hatred end? More than that, what can we do about it? I have written to Rabbi Marks at Beth Orr on more than one occasion after some tragedy has taken the lives of people because I felt compelled to offer our prayers and support. As a nation, we are getting ready to observe the life and legacy of Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who gave his life to the cause of racial injustice. I am confident that Dr. King would speak loud and clear about the recent tragedies that have ripped our country. I will continue to pray and lift up my voice whenever I can or speak out against racism, classism, sexism, and anti-Semitism, and I pray I am not alone. An observance of Dr. King's birthday will be held on January the 19th. Along with the Wissahickon faith community, the annual service of remembrance will be held at Bethlehem Baptist Church at 4:00, beginning at 3:00 with a solidarity march from Wissahickon High School to the church. Several years ago, Rabbi Marks and members of his congregation presented us with religious symbols that we will carry representing our faith community. I urge you to join us as we walk together hand in hand with our Jewish brothers and sisters and with other faith communities in saying love is stronger than hate, and that hate has no place in our community, our country, or the world. Let us walk and worship together along with our children so that they might see a better world where people can live together and respect each other regardless of their ethnicity or faith. This is more than a service honoring Dr. King. It is a service that says we are one. As pastor of a predominantly African-American church, God has spoken to me that we shall no longer be solely an African-American church, but a multicultural church where our vision is to embrace diversity and inclusion. Our lives can be so much better when we are able to see each other through the eyes of God. Let us stand strong together, embracing one another, respecting one another, and loving one another. I am truly grateful to be part of this community and recipient of so much love and kindness. We will not let hate win. We will rise above the horrible crimes that have been committed and remember, as someone said, when they go low, we go high. Peace, love, and shalom.
I look forward to the Martin Luther King service. We will begin at 3:00 with a solidarity walk. I've spoken to Josh Shapiro, our Attorney General. He'll be here along with several elected officials in our community. I have been blessed to be part of this community, as I've written in that letter. And next month, Rabbi Marks, Sean from North Penn and myself will be going to the ADL board to speak about what it means to embrace one another. We're also looking forward in April. We want to take some of our young people that we're going to be taking our young people to the African American Museum and the Holocaust Museum. I know that's a lot to cover in one day, but we want to make sure that we share our commonality in terms of what we have experienced as God's people across the lines of demarcation. So I pray again you would get a copy of the services that have been planned. We have a well-planned services that are scheduled throughout the year. On January 28th, I've been privileged to do the chaplaincy for the Pennsylvania Senate, and I'll be going to Harrisburg to offer a prayer on behalf of the faith community. So a lot of things are going on, and I pray that all of us are honoring God by the way we live, the way we serve, and the way we honor others. I've been really praying about how we as a church can help the people in Australia. And on the fourth Sunday of this month, we're going to take an offering that we're going to send to American Baptist Church as One Great Hour Sharing. We cannot stand silent and see people from all over this world suffering. And I pray you will join us. Today we have our Vision Sunday, and there's an envelope in your packet. I pray that you have brought that envelope. If you have it, you can bring it next Sunday. Next Sunday, Rabbi Marks will be sharing the word at 9 a.m., and Reverend Mark Roberts will be preaching at the second service. And then we will conclude that morning with a time to renew ourselves in spirit and prepare for the walk and then for the service. And I pray that this church is overflowing. If there's anybody who needs to say that we're one, it's the people of God. And we cannot allow the government to take the stand in terms of where they're going. But we, as a people of God, have to speak out. Someone has said, if no one speaks out for others, who will speak out for us? Amen. So now it's time to worship God and pray again that you would come forth. Don't forget our wow as we continue to leave a legacy. We are 132 years old. Somebody came before us. We want to leave something for someone else when they follow us. Amen. Let's worship God through our giving. It's time to give. It's time to give. Thank you. before we have the offertorium, let's raise the praise. Lord, you are great. Church and did not offer God our praise. It would be a sin before God. Let the Redeemer Lord say so. Is God good? Is he worthy to be praised? Let my life praise him. Let my mouth praise him. Let my heart praise him. Let my feet praise him. Let my mind praise him. Let my hands praise him. I was sitting next to Reverend Tripline, and I thought to myself, as he is emerging in ministry, and we recognize those who have been a blessing to us in leadership. We've acknowledged the guests this morning, but we do not want to leave here without praise being the highest level of our worship. Amen. We praise God with our giving. We praise God with our living. And the red carpet has been rolled out so that you will know that when you come to Christ, you're a new creature in Christ. Old things are passed away, all things are new. And I pray this morning, if you're here, that you would take the time to look at your relationship with God. And when the invitation is extended, that you would come forth as a candidate for baptism, Christian experience, or by letter. And this morning when I said to you that I'm glad my name is not on the sick list now, none of us have any idea about what tomorrow holds. Let every day count. And so I pray today that they will count with you and with God, and that you'll get up out of your seat. And when I asked you to ask someone, can I walk with you, you open up your mouth and your heart and simply say with humility and reverence, can I walk with you? Not to be self-righteous, not to be judgmental, but a tender spirit, can I walk with you? Let me hear you say that now before the time comes. Open your mouth and say, can I walk with you? Come on, choir, bless us in song. Thank you.
When you've done all you can, and it seems like it's never enough. And what do you say when your friends turn away? You're all alone, Tell me what when you're giving your all, it seems like you can't make it through. Well, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand, watch the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you just stand. Tell me,
how do you
handle the guilt of your past? Tell me, how do you deal with the shame? And how can you smile when you're heart has been broken and filled with pain, no. Tell me
what
when you've given your all, and it seems like you just can't make it through. Child, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand, watch the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just stand. And be sure, that bondage again, you just stand and do. God has a purpose, son. Somebody say, God has a plan. Tell me, when you've done all you can, and it seems like you just can't make it through. Oh, you just stand, and don't give up. Through the storm, through the rain, through the heartache, and through the pain, don't give in. Stay right there. Stay with them. Oh, hold on. Be strong. The Lord will keep you. It won't be long. Say, hold on to God's unchanging hand. Be right there, through thick and thin. I'm trying to for myself. He will make a way. You just stay right there. Oh, 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 yeah, yeah. Say, after you've done all you can. Oh. After you've gone through the rain, oh, against you like a flood. Oh, after you've done all you can, Lord, yeah. Oh, when you prayed and cried, you prayed and cried, you prayed and cried, oh, yeah. Come on, somebody say, after you've done all you can.
I don't want you to sit. Please stand. I believe as we move in the spirit that there's someone here this morning. I'm going to move beyond our traditional after the sermon. But somebody's here this morning. I want you to stand on the word of God. I'm going to ask Reverend Tripline to sing that again. I'm going to walk down the aisle and somebody's here. God is speaking. Stand on the word of God. Stand with God. Don't let this moment pass and you not say, this day I'm going to give my life to Christ. Sing, brother.
Oh, after you've done all you can. Oh, after you've gone.
Turn to somebody and say, can I walk with you? Can I walk with you? Can I walk with you?
After you've gone through the rain.
Somebody this morning. Somebody this morning, turn to somebody and say, can I walk with you? God is speaking to you.
Oh, you can stand in the rain. Oh, you prayed and cried, you prayed and cried, you prayed and cried, oh Lord. You stayed awake at night, oh
my God. Can I walk with you?
You can.
Can I walk with you? Can I walk with you? Can I walk with you?
You can.
Can I walk with you? Stand on the word of God. 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 Somebody else is here. Stand on the word of God. Stand on the word of God, no matter what you're going through. Stand on his word.
After you've gone through the rain.
Stand on the word of God. Stand on the word of God. Can I walk with you? Trust God enough to step out on faith.
Lord will be with you. Yes,
can I walk with you? Can I walk with you?
Even when your friends have walked away, he will. Even when your family's walked away, the Lord will.
Ask somebody, say, can I walk with you as God walks? Stand on his word.
Done all you can.
He will not leave nor forsake you. He never slumbers or sleeps. Stand on his word. Trust him, trust him. Trust him, trust him. Trust him this morning. Stand on his word.
I know the Lord will make a way.
Stand on his word. Stand on his word. He's dependable. He's reliable. He's trustworthy. You can count on him. No matter what's going on in your life.
Jesus, yes, you can.
Stand on his word.
Stand on his word after you've done all you can.
Just stand, just stand. Our gracious God, we thank you for the movement of the Holy Spirit. May we stand on your word. And oh God, bless me as I will impart to your people that which you have given to me. Use me, God, for your glory, that my words may come forth with clarity and purpose. And somebody even now might be convicted to say, what must I do to be saved? In the mighty name of Jesus Christ do we pray. Amen. Turn in your Bible to the Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 13th chapter, the 7th and 8th verse. The New Living Translation reads in this manner. Other seeds fell among thorns that grew up and choked out the tender plants. Still other seeds fell on fertile soil, and they produced a crop that was 36 and over 100 times as much as been planted. This morning I want to share with you from the subject, A Servant's Heart, part one. A servant's heart. As you take your seat, will you simply say with me, a servant's heart. In the year 2020, we have been asked to win a soul for Christ. It takes a great deal of faith, trust, and dependence on God to be his servant. All of us are servants, regardless of what capacity we might serve in the life of the church. The pastor is a servant. Deacons are servants. Trustees are servants. Deaconess are servants. Choir members are servants. Ushers are servants. We're all servants. And you have to have a servant's heart to serve. You must love people. And if you're going to win a soul for Christ, you may be rejected at times. You cannot be intimidated nor fearful. You have to stand on the word of God. This matter of winning souls for Christ is crucial to our relationship with Jesus Christ. I pray this morning that you have a servant's heart, and the master teaches a parable about how some seeds fell on stony ground and how some seeds fell on fertile ground. Everyone we invite to Christ will not necessarily come. They might even brush us off. Say some things that may be ungodly to us. And if you've never had anybody speak in a negative way because you've asked them to come to the church or to Christ, then maybe you have not asked anybody. Somebody will reject you. Family members will tell you, you're not all that. They'll tell you what you used to do. Well, I feel like preaching it. Why you get so holy? I remember you used to hang out with me and drink with me. Now you're talking about coming to church. So we don't want to say anything because we were reminded of what we used to do. But don't let them remind you of what you used to do. God knows what you used to do, and he still saved you in spite of that. Do I have a witness? So I always ask the question, in your relationship with God, you've been a member of the church for a number of years. How many people have you really won for Christ? How many people know you're a believer? This matter of being a servant is crucial to our everyday relationship with God. And some of us have a hard time, even in the church, of saying, can I walk with you? I just asked you a few moments ago, and some of you were like, you're opening up your heart to somebody. You're not doing it because you want to be self-righteous or judgmental. You're simply saying, I have come to know Christ. I invite you to know him the way I know him because he's been good to me. He's been kind to me. And the same God that's been good to me be good to you. This matter of welcoming people is paramount to the life of the church. To make matters worse, some people are bitter over the events in their life. They come to church bitter. Turn to somebody right now and say, I hope you're not bitter. They've stopped sowing good seed. Be careful what you say. Sow good seeds. My grandmother used to say, if you don't have anything good to say, don't say nothing. Nothing. What kind of seed are you sowing? Stand on this new decade. We need people who are not ashamed to declare that Jesus Christ is Lord of Lords. We're living in a time when people are troubled on every hand. I mentioned the other night at the synagogue when I grew up, my grandmother used to say to me, I want you to be informed. Watch the news. The news can be depressing. I mean, after a while, let me watch the cartoons. And some of them are also depressing. Commercials are depressing. We have to be able to know that God is with us and to encourage people who are going through. Some fell on bad soil, but some fell on good soil. It's amazing what happens. A harvest of blessings come on the good soil. Some of us are now in good soil. Anybody here know what it means to be walking in God's favor? In spite of all that you've gone through, God has still blessed you with a harvest of blessings. Some of us are on good soil, and we don't even know we're on good soil. Every time we speak, it's negative. This is a good day. We serve a good God. We serve a great God. We serve a mighty God. Stand on the word of God. When you cast your seed, it might not grow in the rapid pace that you want. But if you sow good seed, let me put it this way. My grandmother sowed good seed, and I didn't see it. She was telling me what to do, but I decided to do things my own way. But there was still that good seed in me that reminded me of what she said, even though I did not want to pay attention. She sowed good seeds, and I'm a recipient of the good seeds that she sowed. Some of us are now sowing good seed because our grandmothers and our grandfathers and our mothers and fathers put good seed in us. We didn't see it then, but some of us are here now because somebody else planted in us the word of God, the power of God, the love of God. Do I have a witness in the house? And sometimes when we are going through, we wonder what God is doing. We question God. We doubt God. But I'm here to tell you that when you have been planted and rooted by God, he will bring you out of whatever you're going through. None of us will get through this life without some trials and troubles. But when we have been planted and rooted in the Lord, we can get through. Do I have a witness? I cannot even remember the number of couples that I have married And I have literally poured my heart out to them through premarital counseling. And at times I thought that I was just wasting away the time and energy, because some people came because they didn't want to necessarily hear what I had to say, but they wanted to get married in the church, walk down the center aisle. They wanted a church wedding. But I cannot stop because it didn't fall on good ground, because there's some marriages that have lasted. That's the same way in terms of winning folk in the church. You know, some fall on good seed and some come for a moment or two. But if the foundation is there, not only that, but you can't judge because you don't know how the seed you planted will ultimately become a blessing. Sometimes it's not for us to simply win a soul, it's just for us to plant a seed. They don't have to come to Bethlehem. In fact, some of us have children now, and we wonder when that seed will ever grow. Am I talking to anybody? We done planted and planted and planted. We're so tired of planting. We done watered. We done planted. We done prayed. We done done everything. We done dug the ground all over again. And they still doing that stuff. But you can't give up. Anybody here have a child that's going in the wrong direction? Our responsibility as parents is to plant the seed. Let God do the harvesting. Do I have a witness here? We have a responsibility. And some will fall on bad ground, but God could even take the bad ground and turn it into good ground. Do I have a witness here? Some of us know for ourselves. Soil fall is doesn't have much depth. It's surface. Everything that looks good is not good. Everything that shines is not gold. Be careful what you're looking at. You think that's a good life? You don't know what you're getting into. Build your house on a solid foundation. I wish I could make this clear, because don't get caught up in materialism. And I don't want you to misunderstand me. It's good to have things, particularly if you've come from a situation where you've not been blessed with a lot of things. But don't let those things consume you. That's shallow. That ground will not last. In fact, I would also argue, don't even build your life on your energy and health and strength or your looks. I look good. I don't look the same way I used to look when I was 20. I didn't have any gray hair. I had a little bit more pep in my step. And guess what? You don't look the way you used to look either. You cannot build that shallow. And it's also shallow even when you build on financial blessings, because you brought nothing with you and you'll take nothing when you leave. I said this morning to the leaders who came to pray with me that, and I say this all the time, you hoarding stuff here, guess what? When you're gone, it's going to be all gone. And I made myself an example, because I said before, and I've heard this before, I got a nice tie on. You can't see it, but guess what? When I die, my sons don't want they don't even want it now. They want, Dad, where you get that tie from? Back, you know what? You know what's really funny? I only got a few minutes, but, you know, I like the William Penn Inn. I go there for dinner. I go there, have opportunity to meet with colleagues and things. And my son said, Dad, why you go to William Penn? All them old people are there. That's what he says, kid. I'm like, wait a minute. It's threw me under the bus. But I cannot build my life on going to the William Penn Inn. That is a shaky foundation. I can't even build my life on 106 Regency Drive. That's a shaky foundation. Gotta build on things that are eternal. Gotta sow good seed. Examine this parable. Soil, the sower, described by Jesus. The sower is a servant. That's what we are. And you have to have a servant's heart to sow. You have to be concerned about others. Winning a soul for Christ is not just something we do to try to increase the membership. It's a responsibility that God has given to us out of the Great Commission. Go into all the world. That's what we've been called to do. Wonderful parable about those who are disconnected. Sometimes I've asked myself, what kind of soil am I standing on? It does not take long to become comfortable with worldly pleasures. You don't mind if I preach a little bit, do you? You know, flat screen TVs. I remember when I had one TV. And my grandmother and my mother, some of you don't know, you millennials, they don't know nothing about this. But, you know, before they had, I don't know, let me see, find me a sinner. Not a sinner, a senior. I figured I'd get your attention there. So does anybody remember when you had black and white TVs and then you put a piece of across your TV and make it color? Now some of you don't remember that. We're blessed with a fireplace in our home. But I remember going to the store and get a cardboard fireplace. Now, you don't remember that.
No.
You're not from the hood. See, I'm from the hood. We had cardboard fireplaces, particularly around Christmas. The point I'm trying to make, you can't build on that kind of soil. It will not last. All of our accomplishments, and as valuable as they are, still do not put us in a relationship with God. We have to make sure that we're doing what God has called us to do. Now, please don't walk away saying the pastor put down this, put down that. I like nice things, but they have its place. And I don't want them to place God in my life. Because that can be a fertile soil. Reach out to people. Make life different for people. I close on this. Every morning, the Church Without Walls, where we had over 100 people this week, I end by this. Forgive someone. Anyone who's not forgiving is building on soil that will not last. A servant's heart is always forgiving. This is what I told this young preacher right here, and I'll tell you. The most important thing is not how well one can preach, not how well one can go through the scripture, not how one can give oratorial presentation, not how one can sing, is that do you love people? Do you love people? And if you love people, you would invite them to come to Christ. And when they reject you, you will not take it personal. Like you do when the telemarketer comes. Slam, don't talk to me. So I'm giving you 101. The next time a telemarketer calls your house, I'm serious. Don't slam the phone up. Don't use profanity. Don't call here no more. You don't know, that may be an opportunity for you to win a soul for Christ. And they're just working. I'm finished. Do you have it? I'm finished. Do you have it? Now, some of you have said, I don't care what the pastor said, I'm going to just hang up on him. You only discredit yourself and God by doing that. And you're much more valuable than that. That could be your son or daughter who just started in the first job. Amen. Did you hear what I said? That could be your son or daughter that just started on their first job. The doors of the church are open. Won't you come now? What was the sermon entitled? Do you have a servant's heart? If so, will you turn to somebody and simply say, can I walk with you? Turn to somebody right now and say, can I walk with you? Twice this morning we've asked you, can I walk with you as Christ walks with me? Twice is a charm. This is your time. Can I walk with you? Can I walk with you? Can I walk with you? I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Somebody this morning. Because you came for me in such a marvelous way. In such a marvelous way. Somebody this morning. Why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. I love you, Lord. God bless you. I love you. I love you.
I love you, Lord, today.
Because
you came for me
in such a marvelous way.
In such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with pain.
One more time.
I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today.
This morning, I pray that you have already received your gift-giving envelopes. And I want to personally thank Debbie Badger, who has worked so diligently in terms of putting together some technology so that there'll be opportunities for us to even be able to give far beyond the envelopes. But I'm going to ask this morning on this second Sunday that you would sow into this church a vision offering. Envelopes in the packet, but we want this year to be one by which it is incredible to God and to God's people. When I got home last night after being out all day, I got a wonderful email